my, your, all of our confusion. What can happen with just one?
What can be done by a single seed?
What cannot be done by a single seed? By a single seed, another 1,000 seeds can become ready to be sown, and an entire farm can grow.
What can be done by a single ray of light?
What cannot be done by a single ray of light? By a single ray of light, darkness can be penetrated.
What can be done by taking a single step?
By taking a single step in the right direction, we can quickly reach our destination.
What can be done in a single hour?
What cannot be done in a single hour? It was in June 1958 at about 6 o'clock in the evening. A Surat railway station platform, bustling with people. Ambalal Bhai Patel was sitting on a bench on platform number 3, waiting for a train. At that time, suddenly, in just 1 hour, the whole universe came into his vision. The truth behind all spiritual mysteries was revealed. All the realities of the world came into his experience, and he fully experienced the self. A phenomenal wonder was created, and the world got a unique, unparalleled Akram scientist, Param Pujya Dada Bhagwan. Anger, pride, deceit, greed, attachment and abhorrence were destroyed. The sense of ownership of the mind, speech, and body did not remain. After attaining self-realization, his ego dissolved completely. The Lord within became free from all the veils of ignorance. The ignorance of infinite lives went away in just 1 hour.
What can be done by a single intention?
What cannot be done by keeping a single intention for infinite lives?
Until he left his body, he had only this intention, that of, how can everyone attain this?
He had this intention for many lifetimes. May the world attain salvation. All the living beings of the world, they are the self. Why should they suffer so much pain? It is only due to a lack of understanding. Nothing but infinite types of misunderstandings are causing people to suffer. So how can the misunderstandings leave? To begin with, he first dissolved his own lack of understanding.
What can be done by a single man?
What cannot be done by a single man? The whole world can be put on the right track.
His intention was that if I become pure and if I meet 10 people, then I will give them the understanding. So another will become pure, and seeing him, another too will become pure. If one were to improve, he improved 100%, and then whomever he met, he explained to them, and their suffering began to leave. He was certain that the other person's suffering would leave by giving him such an understanding. Even if he were to progress 1 degree or 1 step from the path of the worldly life to the path of liberation, a step forward on the path of the absolutely detached Lords, only then will he find peace. So he experienced this right knowledge, this right understanding, and began giving it to whomever he met. He was certain that if he gave them such understanding, their suffering would leave. Dada says, "I want to put the entire world on the right track. I want to introduce the real God to the world. God exists, and he is in this form." And he had the intention for the salvation of the world for so many lifetimes. The seed of the absolutely detached Lords has been planted and is spreading. Now the salvation of the world will indeed happen.
ज्ञात पिता हो ज्ञानी जी प्रगट दादा भगवंत ज्ञात पुत्र हूँ आपनो तम थकी छे भव अंत
दादा भगवान टू हुम वी सेज दादा भगवान From so many lives, he was searching about what is reality, what is universal truth. In this life, he got the spiritual knowledge in 1958. From that time, he says, I separated from my mind, speech and body, and myself, total separation take place. And I have no worry, no stress, complete bliss all the time. And that science we can say is a akram vijnan. Akram means stepless path for achievement of self-realization. There are two type of path in this world. One is step by step, step by step, step by step. We have to do something to achieve self-realization. Doing some meditation, some worship, some chanting some mantra or some penance or some living our home, wife, everything, and doing sadhana or for our finding out who am I. But that is a long, long, long path. It is possible in that path also, in presence of Tirthankar like Lord Mahavir, or say Lord Krishna, in presence of enlightened person, we can terminate our journey for our self-realization. But due to our merit karma, Dada Bhagwan in this time, he got such a spiritual knowledge, and this is not step-by-step path. It is stepless path or say elevator path. Within 2 hours, we can get our realization.
Gnan Vidhi. The scientific experiment of self-realization.
I am pure soul.
I am pure soul.
I am pure soul.
I am pure soul.
I am pure.
It is because of our immense merit karma that we have attained the knowledge of the self through Gnanvidhi. Taking Gnan is like sowing a seed. It is an initiation on the path of liberation. To achieve ultimate liberation, moksha, all karma need to be dissolved with the help of these five agnas. The agnas are not to be chanted, but are for our understanding and are to be applied in all our day-to-day dealings. The five principles, agnas. From the relative viewpoint, I am Chandubai. Here, substitute your name for Chandubai. From the real viewpoint, I am pure soul. The world is governed by scientific circumstantial evidences, Vyavasthit Shakti. Settle all files with equanimity. Accumulate credit in the account of the pure soul.
I've been a seeker for many years. I've tried many different spiritual paths. But there was this conviction and this belief, this faith that there was such a thing as truth and that someday I hope to find it, that true knowledge and true self-awakening was possible. And then after receiving Gnan, there's for me a subtle experience of this separation between the self and the non-self, or the pure soul and body-mind complex. And that experience in and of itself was not one of the most powerful experiences I've ever had. But the use of the five principles or five agnas has allowed me to continue in the growing understanding of the self, of the true self. And I can see that as those karmas are discharging, I have a better understanding of why this is happening, and the knowledge that I am pure soul remains and actually grows stronger.
So every step we want to keep this practice of five principles. Every day morning, you have to take decision. I want to remain whole day in five principles in my each and every phases. By grace, you are getting this knowledge. So you, from your side, you have to make purushartha, strong nischay and decision. I want to remain in five principles.
Or rather clarify the five principles to the fullest possible extent, please.
This is only important part, and if you practice more and more, you will get full experience of pure soul. First principle, by relative viewpoint, I am Chandi. By real viewpoint, I am pure soul. See, previously we have only one viewpoint. I am Chandi, it is correct. I am husband, I am father, I am... But really, you are father? Yes, I am father. But you say, I am husband. Oh, with respect to wife, you are husband. But with respect to son, you are father. So you are really father, really husband? No, it is relatively husband, relatively father. So really, you are pure soul. That in previously, we believe that really I am Chandi. But it is also relative. Because after your birth, name is given. So before name, you are there. But slowly, slowly, you have to practice that. But now, you have to just understand, you have to just practice. Oh, this is just like Chandi is separate from you. I am pure soul, Chandi is separate from me. Like, you have to see everybody. See relative viewpoint. He is a pecking and really he is a sure soul. Cow, animals, birds, human, everything by two viewpoint you have to start practicing. So, this is first two principles.
At the same time.
Same time means whenever you're free, you are just walking, suppose you are in office, somebody comes, so immediately you have to, oh see, he is a customer, relatively he is a pure soul. Now do your work, ask Chandi to do his work, your manager, talk with him, whatever. But in inside, see, sometimes some commissioner is there. When he comes to your home, do you feel something? And some layman comes to your home, is there any difference? Inside you feel, he's commissioner, I have to give some respect, I have to help him or some serve him good way. So here you have to keep awareness, he's a pure soul, like Dada Bhagwan. His pure soul like Mahavir Bhagwan. His pure soul like me. To keep awareness, slowly that will come to you.
Vyavasthit, scientific circumstantial evidences. Any single work or incident in our life involves a number of factors called scientific circumstantial evidences. The end result of combined actions of all the evidences is called vyavasthit.
Who is the doer? That knowledge we are getting in Jnana ceremony. You says, I am doer. You can do whatever, suppose you want to make one cup of tea. You can able to prepare one cup of tea? What you will say?
Yeah.
Yes, easy.
Yes.
Easy, no? But you required tea bag, water, pot, milk, everything is required, stove. So you are individually, without help of anything, you can able to prepare one cup of tea?
Yeah.
Yes. Without help of anything.
I need the tea and the different ingredients, but the rest I'm doing.
But suppose some back pain started, pain in our joint, something, and we cannot get up from bed. Then how can you prepare?
No, I can't do it.
So many evidences required. Physical body, mind, hand, leg, brain, outer stove, sugar, pot, milk, tea bag. And time also required. Space also required. Now you can able to make, now immediately you prepare one cup of tea. It is not possible. Kitchen is also required. So many things is required. So we are just making tea and say, I am doer. I am speaking, I am doing, I came here. But you are really coming here with the help of evidence. Evidence pull you to come here. So we are believing that I am doer. So whatever happened is required so many evidence, and we says I am doer. That is biggest blunder. Whatever comes, evidence, is a result of scientific circumstantial evidence. If it becomes good or something happens good, then we have to understand, I am not doer, file one, and scientific circumstantial evidence has done this. Something happened bad. So we should not blame on anybody. It is also a result of scientific circumstantial evidence. And really, whatever happens is a result of past karma. Whatever we have made causes in past life, that comes one by one effect in this life. Just like when we write an examination in school, then after 20 days, teacher will give us result. The result, we cannot do anything for result. Teacher is also giving result according to what we have written in examination. So whatever we have written, that is corrected by teacher and result is given.
just like Yavasi Shakti, whatever we have made causes in the past, Yavasi Shakti, scientific, circumstantial evidence gives result in this life. So result cannot change, result cannot stop, result cannot control. But we can observe result. We can know and see what file one is suffering, which type of causes and which type of effect comes. We are knower and seer. So for result, we should not blame on anybody, because whatever effect comes to us is a result of our causes. So nobody is responsible for our causes. So whatever effect comes is also nobody is responsible. We should not blame on anybody. We have to just understand how effect comes by scientific circumstantial evidence.
Suppose you have finished some work. So if evidences occurs, then only you can finish your work. If evidences is lacking, you cannot finish that work. So you should not blame on anybody. Due to you, you are not supporting, that's why I cannot finish my work. He's not responsible. Scientific, circumstantial evidence are the responsible. So like that, you have to practice this third principle. Scientific, circumstantial evidence are the doer. In our language, Dada says, Vyavasthit Shakti, whatever happen is correct, always correct, never incorrect. You are in sleep, though. Who has woken up you? Scientific circumstantial evidence. Who make you hungry? Scientific circumstantial evidence. Who supply this food? Scientific circumstantial evidence. So from every stage of in our life, if we whatever happen, nobody is individual doer, it is a result of scientific circumstantial evidence only. So here we want to keep awareness, two type of awareness. When I am separate and Chandi is separate, and Chandi is doing, he is one of the evidence among all scientific circumstantial evidence. Nobody is individual doer, only scientific circumstantial evidence are the doer, and every person within, he is a pure soul. So soul is not doer at all, and persons are really not 100% doer. He is out of so many evidence, he is one of the evidence. So if we, our vision is clear, our understanding is clear, then only our doership will dissolve. If I know everything, then only I can come out from doership. And if I don't have doership, then only I cannot charge new karma. So by experience, Dada has given word. Apply this word. Scientific circumstantial evidence are the doer. If you see, if you cannot see, but if you apply this word, then also you will be come out from your doership. And you can remain in pure soul. Somebody is not giving any money, so you have to understand, he is also in problem of circumstantial evidences, he is not doer. Means we have to just follow his commandments. So it will give same result as he is experiencing. So we don't want to see anybody as in fault. We want to see everybody as a faultless vision. See, relatively he is faultless, really he is also faultless. And if you see fault of anybody, that is a charging part. And if we see everybody as a faultless, your karma will dissolve. And due to ignorance, if we blame anybody, automatically we will feel unhappiness inside. And if we see innocent everybody, then we feel happiness every time. So this is science. This is spiritual science.
When we marry, is it already decided or predestined whether that marriage is going to last for the entire life?
We don't know. After, suppose I have, yesterday I explained you, one glass is in my hand. So I know if it is falling down, then I have to save that glass up to last moment. Positive effort for saving this glass up to last moment. Then it falls down and breaks. Then only I can say whatever happened is correct. Otherwise, if I throw away and then say, this is vyavasthit, this is not correct. I should not throw away, but I should protect him up to last moment. After breaks, then only we can say whatever happened is result of scientific circumstantial evidence. Whatever happened is a result of past karma. But after finishing that, then we can say, but before we cannot say this is going to happen, whole life is decided. Whatever happened, positive and negative, two result. So our effort is for positive result only, no negativity. Then happens after so many try, still it doesn't fulfill, then it breaks, then we will accept whatever happened is result of past karma. You understood?
Yeah, Jai Satchitana.
Jai Satchitana.
Settle all files with equanimity. The people or circumstances which we come across in our life are because of our own karmic account. Pujya Dada Bhagwan has given this a special name, file. Just as when we solve an office file fully, it does not bother us anymore, in the same manner, if we solve situations, files, in our life with equanimity, that is, without any attachment or hatred, our karma get dissolved to that extent and we will feel the inner bliss.
Yes. Yesterday I can't understand about the files. What are the files? There's the four arganas.
File.
Yeah, file.
It's the fourth agna. Yeah. Yeah. You yourself is pure soul. In reality, you are pure soul. And Urmil is your first neighbor, is called file number one. We are giving code names. Code names were given by Dada, that file number one. Urmil is your file number one.
Yeah.
Now, those who are in your close relations, attachment or hatred, these are all the causes of relations. So now try to give the numbers according to your attachment and hatreds. So now file number two, now you don't have that file number two. So now remain 3, 4, 5, those all are 6, 7, you are all relatives, in-laws, brother, sister, daughter, son, daughter-in-law. These are all your files. Friend circle, where you were, they are also all your files. So now this fourth agna says you clear all these files, keeping equilibrium inside. No attachment, no hatred for anybody. Same for everyone. You should have same feeling throughout. No hatred, no attachment, no rag, no dvesh. Sambhav, it's called sambhav. That is called equilibrium. Balance inside, you should have balance.
Balance. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Equanimity means, suppose some good food is there, then don't get attached. And some bad food or some tasteless food, then don't be unhappy. This is file I want to solve with equanimity. Keep both same. In ignorance, we are believing I am eater. That's why some tasteless food, we become angry. And who is the doer? We are blaming on that person. He is not preparing good food. And it is good food, then we are appreciating that person. Oh, nice food, we are preparing very good food. So attachment will be there. That attachment and hatred is a non-equanimity. But if I know I am not eater, I am knower and seer, and whatever comes, it is with file one, then I can keep equanimity. This is file I want to solve with equanimity. Tasty food or not tasty food, we will keep same, not equilibrium for both evidences. Some bad person or good person, you want to keep same intent with both. No hatred for bad person, no attachment for good person. If we practice five agnas, then automatically we will see that bad person is separate and pure soul is separate. So automatically equanimity will come. Our opinion is he is a bad person, then automatically hatred will start for that person. But now we can see bad person is separate and pure soul is separate. Whatever he is doing bad thing, it is discharge karma of that person. It is discharge of past life karma. So he is not responsible today for bad karma. So if we understand this science, then automatically hatred, revenge, bad negativity, everything will dissolve automatically. Fourth principle is files. You are pure soul, chandi is file number one. Wife inside is pure soul. Relative part is file number two. Children's file number three, four. Father, mother, five, six. Father-in-law, mother-in-law, seven, eight. These are the nearest file. So sticky file, to whom we have more attachment. So these are the files. Sometimes abhorrence is there, dislike some people, that is also file. So we have to understand this. These are my files, I want to clear all files with equanimity. We are in state of wrong belief, we cannot have equanimity. While with right understanding, right knowledge, automatically it results equanimity. Somebody hurt you, if you see he is pure soul, he has not hurt me, he has hurt to Chandi, relative part is doer, and it is a result of scientific circumstance. Due to my causes, he is one of the instrument, he is giving effect, I am pure soul. So if you practice these five principles, automatically you will be in equanimity. So if you are in equanimity, so there is no charge of new karma. Due to rag, dves, attachment, hatred, you are charging karma. So these are scientific principles. If you apply, automatically your karma is not going to charge. So see, worldly peoples are not files. But to whom we have attachments, earth files. And if you are having that, food is also file, your habit for tea is also file, your like, dislike are also files. You say, I don't want this old cold nature, I want some hot weather, it is file for you. So your clothing, everything is file. But inside you have to keep, this is file, I want to clear it out. So previously, what we are doing, adopting good things, leaving bad things. Now, bad things or good things, bad deed or good deed, everything we want to dissolve now. We want to solve. We don't want any attachment with good deeds, no abhorrence with bad deeds. We don't want one like or dislike with any positive, negative. We want to dissolve everything. And we want to get absolute stage of pure soul. So this is our ultimate goal in this life. I want full experience of pure soul and I want to clear my all files. And if there are some sticky file, you have to do pratikaman for that. Because up to this life we have so many negativity or positivity or bad opinion, good opinion for so many peoples. So each and every, so your father, your mother, open that file from childhood to today. What are the opinion given to father? What are the negativity? What are the mistake I have seen in my father? You have to clear. He is pure soul. Relative part is due to circumstantial evidence. It is some karmic account of Chandi. I don't want to blame them. So slowly you sit down, do introspection, clear your father's file, then take another file, mother's file, sister, brother, then wife. Every slowly, each and every person, we have to clear our files. So we want to clear our files. And if you don't have any file, then you find out what are the mistake in our mind, intellect, or our attachment, hatred. We have to introspection inside only. And we have to clear all mistakes. Because so nobody, not a single evidence or not a single person can bind us. Only our mistake and blunders, due to that we are in this world. Now your blunders has been broken yesterday in Gnanvidhi, Gnan ceremony. Now you have to clear all mistakes. And if you practice five principles, then your mistake will go away. And you feel liberation, inner happiness, everything.
मन वचन काया फाइलो जानी संभावे निकाल करे जे शुद्धात्मा छु लक्ष्य अनुभव प्रतीति ना जाए रे शुद्धात्मा छु लक्ष्य अनुभव प्रतीति ना जाए रे
The spiritual activities which raise our awareness and help us to remain in Gnan will credit in the account of the pure soul. Examples are attending live satsang of Pujya Deepak Bhai, regular samayik and pratikraman, reading Pujya Dada Bhagwan's books and watching satsangs on TV or online.
In fifth agna, we have to practice five agnas. We have to do satsang, read Charanvidhi, read Dada's book. Why we are reading Dada's book, Dada Bhagwan book? They are practically, whenever Dada Bhagwan doing satsang, people asking question and Dada Bhagwan is given answer. But that answer is how to remain in a stage of pure soul, how to solve our files with equanimity, how to practice five agna is maximum explanation is how to remain in a stage of pure soul. That explanation is given by Dada Bhagwan. So if we read that book, our practical problem, we will get explanation, we will get understanding how to keep awareness of pure soul and how to solve our worldly problems with equanimity. This Charanvidhi is also helpful because in Charanvidhi we are asking strength to remain in a stage of pure soul, as well as we are worshipping our inner pure soul and we want to become merge with oneness with our inner pure soul. So we are, our intellect, ego will dissolve and awareness and strongness of pure soul stage will increase by practicing Charanvidhi. Everything mentioned in Charanvidhi is very helpful for our spiritual progress. So every day, at least half an hour, 1 hour, you have to spend and read Dada's book, read Charanvidhi. And very important thing, we have to, in the morning, we have to decide, I want to remain in a five agnas, five principles. Every day, we have to decide, I want to practice five agnas. And before sleep again, do meditation, I am pure soul, I am pure soul. Within 10 minutes, 15 minutes, half an hour, automatically sleep will come. While one gets sleep and you are in a stage of awareness of pure soul, powerful awareness, strength will increase. And from morning till night, we have to use this five agna. Before sleep, do meditation of pure soul. Again in the morning decide, I want to remain in five agna. Practice five agnas. do satsang here locally. They are doing satsang. By Zoom satsang, you can join in video satsang. That will helpful for progress. And also you can come in program in India, Simandar city. That will helpful for you for spiritual progress.
Okay, I have the feeling I can't put that all this year into practice in my daily life. I'm living alone, just with a dog.
You can join with Zoom satsang. Every day they are at least half an hour, 1 hour, they are doing satsang in Zoom. So you can connect yourself in Zoom satsang and enjoy this satsang. And whatever other activity you are doing, you can do. When you go for walk, see everybody as a pure soul. In dog also, you have to see pure soul. In old people home, when you go, see them as a pure soul inside. And whatever file you have to finish, finish with equanimity. And one more thing, you can join Zoom satsang with these people. Every day, in the morning, they are doing vidhi, in satsang, something, whatever they are doing, just get information and connect through internet in Zoom satsang. Understood?
Yeah. Thank you.
This is Dada family. So now you are not alone. You are with Dada family. So everybody will, you are joining our family.
Yeah, I have the same feeling. Thank you very much.
Okay.
I wrote this question yesterday morning before the Gnan Vidhi. So I think it's almost answered already by what you taught us this morning. My question was, how can we prevent to fall back into old habits when we come home after this weekend? So I think with the five agnas, we can. So thank you.
Your answer is correct. Five agna, as well as join the satsang program. Live relay is there, weekend satsang, Zoom satsang. So be in touch with the satsang. Not just like we brought some new machine, then will anything happen, we will check manual. What is wrong? Why this is happening? Why this red signal is coming? So we will check in manual. Like the Dada's book is a manual. Anything happen, we have to study and find out solution and be in touch with satsang.
Okay, thank you.
And every day we have to decide, I want to remain, practice five agnas. And before sleep, just 10-15 minutes check where I miss my five agna. To whom I have not seen pure soul, to whom I have not said this is file, whatever happens, where I have seen anybody is a doer. So find out fault and correct by practicing five agna. That will help you. Slowly, slowly your awareness will increase, experience of pure soul will increase, and then stable condition will come. All the time you are free from all relative things, remain in a stage of pure soul.
Thank you.
Jai Sachidana.
Deepak Bhai, I want to know, what is the importance of Charan Vidhi and why we need to do Charan Vidhi every day?
We must do this Charan Vidhi every day. Because in Gnan Vidhi, Gnan ceremony, what we achieve is a realization of pure soul. But it is in only belief. It helps for our awareness of pure soul. From belief, we have to come to awareness, and from awareness, we will reach to experience. So all the time we want awareness of pure soul, awareness in remaining five principles. So this Charan Vidhi help for everything. In Charan Vidhi, we are praying to our pure soul with all properties and how we are separate from mind, speech and body, and how to we have to remain in our pure soul. In Gnan Vidhi, we have four seed of pure soul. Now, this is five principles are the protection for pure soul, and this is fertilizer.
And in all, there are so many sentences, it reached to, our vision reached to absolute stage of pure soul. So very important, we have to do this charanvidhi. This must, vidhi means we have to do, this is must. Every day, how, why we are eating food, why we are taking breakfast, like, this is for relative part, and this charanvidhi is a food for real part. Very important to do every day. Dada Bhagwan says, if you have time, you do twice, thrice, or 10 times. This is your, any time you can do before shower or after shower, after meal, whenever you are free. But your concentration should be there. It should be continuous, not in breaking two or three stage. No disturbance of chit. Your concentration, you can do in say full concentration and say little loudly. So your concentration will be remain in whole charanvidhi. Then only you will get full benefit of charanvidhi.
Not coincidentally, I'm sure, I had stopped reading the charanvidhi, and not completely, but you know, I got lazy. I wasn't really committed as I was in the beginning, because I didn't have that high anymore and life was overwhelming me again. I decided to open the charanvidhi again. And I noticed with the charanvidhi, I didn't mind, and the more I did it, the more I enjoyed doing it. Very profound, not in a thunderbolt kind of a way. It's really subtle. I'm sure I have many more years of work ahead of me, but it's the first time I really feel that something is authentic, very real, and with absolutely no agenda, nothing to be frightened of, very loving, and very much a feeling of home. That's what it feels like here. But for me, it's quite profound.
Please explain the meaning of Dada Bhagwana Asim Jai Jai Kar Ho, and what is the correct way to recite?
It is really prayer to the pure soul within us only. Dada Bhagwan means enlightened pure soul within A.M. Patel. So we are praying same pure soul within us only. Because we reach only the interim government stage, I am pure soul. We want to reach full stage of pure soul by praying inside Dada Bhagwan, inside pure soul. So Dada Bhagwan means inside pure soul, and when we pray this Dada Bhagwan Asim Jai Jai Kar, at that time we are visualizing each and every words. So our chit become pure, and pure chit will merge in our pure soul, as well as we are praying enlightened pure soul. So our energy, our knowledge, vision, bliss, everything will uncovered. So our all energy of pure soul, properties of the pure soul will uncover by praying Dada Bhagwana Asim Jai Jai Kar Ho.
Pratikraman. The behavior with anyone where nobody is hurt by us is called Kraman. If someone is hurt by our mind, body or speech, either knowingly or unknowingly, that is called Atikraman. To become free from the faults of Atikraman, we must repent heartily and apologize to the pure soul within the person who is hurt by us. This is called Pratikraman. That is, to retract from our own faults.
Very important part. We want to clear all files. If we hurt anybody, then he may take revenge, and that is a bondage of karma, and that we have to finish in next life. And we don't want to continue our life cycle in this earth. We want to finish all karma, and we want to reach to ultimate moksha, salvation. So we have to clear all files. Not necessary within one day only. Slowly, slowly, slowly. But you have to keep in mind that I want to clear this file, I want to clear this file. and they are only hardly 3, 4, 5, 8, 10. And in today, day-to-day life, we have to check whether in the morning to night, we have to check whether anybody is hurt with in connection with me, somebody may hurt or not. If he's hurt, then we have to do pratikaman for that. So that every day we have to check. And by whose mistake we should not check. If I hurt anybody, it is 100% my mistake. Then we will keep inside awareness that I am pure soul, Chandi has done this mistake. And ask Chandi to do pratikamana. If we do pratikamana, that is, it won't, our whole mistake, complete mistake will not go away. Only one layer of our mistake will go away. Same mistake may repeat again after some time. We have to do pratikamana second time. Means your pure soul, Chandi, has to do pratikamana second time, third time, fourth time. Slowly, suppose some mistake has 50 layer, so we have to do 50 times pratikamana. Some mistake has only 5 layer, so within 5 times pratikamana it will completely go away. And in between husband and wife, 50,000 layer, it will take more time to clear our file.
Jnan laine thayo atmano anand ke visundar thai amari dasha dada bhagwan ne varse adbhut kripa भागे चिंता बधी भागे दुख ना बधा ज्ञान लईने थयो.
I have a question about the five agnyas, and something that I think sometimes confuses me is the word practice with the five agnyas, because before Gyanvidhi, my understanding of practice, or how I was practicing something, was Christian file number one was doing stuff.
Yeah.
And nowadays, sometimes what happens is I catch myself, or I see file number one is trying to do the five agnyas, and that seems to be a doomed endeavor, that doesn't work. So when, maybe it's just I get hooked up on this word and my previous understanding of the word practice. So could you please clarify what practice here with the five agnyas really means? Because it's obviously different from practices.
See, in previous practice we required some instruments, some evidences. Here we doesn't require any evidences, only awareness. You have to just decide, I want to remain in five principles. And I want keep awareness, whatever Christian is doing, this is file number one. Whatever he is doing is one of the evidence for out of scientific circum evidence. This is relative, this I am real. So this is awareness. So practicing means practice for awareness. So you have to decide, I want to remain, I want to follow these principles. But these are principles, is not required any evidences. It requires only understanding. What is relative, what is real, what is file, who am I? This is only understanding. So by understanding, we have to keep this understanding, awareness of this understanding. So practicing means you have to just understand how this is separate, how I have to become, I have to remain in pure soul, how I should remain as a knower and seer. This you have to understand. This satsang, we are not giving any explanation for doership or doing anything. We are giving you just understanding only. How to keep separate, how to see your own faults, how to do pratikamana, but these are only understandings. What are the mistakes? If you know, then only you can come out from that mistakes. And this is only vision given to you.